I just want you in your
I just want you more. I just want you.
New horizons. just begun. We've only just begun. We've only just begun. We've only just begun. Oh, there's more. And oh, there's more.
Those who knock, the door will be open.
never been before. There's new horizons. There's new horizons. There's new horizons. We're pressing in. We're pressing in. We're pressing in.
And I just wanna be where you are. To you are all things.
so worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
You are worthy.
worship around your throne. They'll worship around your throne. Day and night, night and day. Day and night, night and day. The one who is glorious. The one who is worthy. We worship you. We worship you. Worship you, we worship you, joining in with the angels, joining in with the elders as they cry out, glory to the one who's seated on the throne, glory to the is the kingdom, yours is the power, Yours is the power, yours is the glory, yeah. Yours is the kingdom, yours is the power, and yours is the glory, yeah. Oh, we cry glory to the one who's seated on the throne, yeah. Seated on the throne, he is worthy, oh, he is worthy of all the glory, of all the honor, and all the praise. Oh, he is worthy of all the glory and all the honor. Oh,
Father, we recognize that all the power is yours, God. Nothing that we do is from our strength. It's from your grace. God, yours is the glory. Lord, everything we do, it's for you. That you would be magnified, that you would be glorified, that you would receive the praises. It's not for us. It's not to make our names great. Not that you mind or would be offended, but Lord, our desire is to make your name great, greater than our name. And Lord, yours is the kingdom forever. And God, that is what we set our eyes on. That is what we look to. That's what we draw all this from. It's from your kingdom. It's from that mindset. So Lord, as we pray, as we go into your word, we pray that you would transform our minds, transform our hearts, God. That we would have a right understanding of what it means to be blessed, what it means to be in your kingdom, God. So God, come. Come tonight. Reveal your kingdom to us tonight, God. We ask this in your name, Lord. Amen. Yeah. So right now, we are going to transition into time of interceding through the word. Tonight's passage is Matthew 11, verses 3 through, or 5, verses 3 through 10. So I ask that you guys open your Bibles to Matthew 5 and go through the passage with us as we meditate tonight. Matthew 5, verse 3 says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted." God, it's in times of trouble, in times of doubt, in times of weakness that we have a hard time seeing your blessing. We look at the world around us, the state of ourselves, and we consider ourselves not blessed or even cursed. The world tells us, our experience seems to tell us that blessing is found in wealth or in success or in fame. Our experience tells us that we can't be happy unless we have these things, unless our dreams are come true. And so God, we come tonight understanding that we don't know what true blessing is. We confess that we want to know. So shift our hearts and minds, God. And so Lord, maybe when we look at our failures and weaknesses, we recognize that you don't look down on us. You tell us that it's even in our weakness, in our brokenness, in our poverty of spirit, that we will inherit the kingdom. You're glad to give the kingdom to those who are broken. Lord, our heroes of faith, the men and women in the Bible that we read about, are broken as we are. And so we find our hope in you. We find our hope in Scripture. God, you tell us that here today we can still bring your kingdom to the earth. You still allow us, even in our brokenness, to minister to people around us, to intercede for the nations, to steward the gifts that we were given, to make an impact in this world. And so we see that we don't have anything to fret about. But in fact, we are blessed even in our poverty. And God, there is a very real mourning that we also experience in this life. We lose people, relationships. We lose our belongings, our houses, our homes, our money. We even lose our dreams. We give up. We face walls that we can't overcome. And we mourn. And you don't call us foolish for mourning. But you do call us to find our comfort in you. God, in the world, there is no hope. There's no way to see a light at the end of the tunnel. But we have hope in you. That even amongst our losses, we stand to gain greater things, God, eternal things. And so we find our comfort in you. We look for our comfort in you, God. We turn to you. Lord, you love us so deeply and you care for us so intimately. And so we find comfort in you, God. We find our comfort in you.
Of those who mourn, yeah. Of those broken for us, that we might be healed, that we might be healed.
Yes.
There is a King who is broken. There is a King who is broken, that we might be healed, that we might be healed.
Heal us, God.
There is a King who is broken. There is a King who is broken, that we might be healed.
You give us strength.
That we might be healed.
You restore our strength.
There is a King who is broken. There is a King who is broken, that we might be healed. That we might be healed. He says, come to the poor in spirit. He says, come to those who are mourning. Oh, he says, come and find life. Come find life in me.
Find life in him.
He says, come to those who are hungry. He says, come to those who are thirsty, and you shall live. Oh,
eternal life.
You shall live.
An overflowing well.
For there is life everlasting. There is life everlasting. For those who mourn,
it'll never run dry.
Oh, he says come,
it'll never run
to those
out.
Who are hungry and thirsty. Oh, he says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty. Oh, he says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty. Oh, he says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty. Oh, he says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty. Oh, he says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty. Oh, he says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty.
We go to you.
He says come, to those who are hungry and thirsty, oh, we turn to you. 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 Turn to you with our brokenness.
You're the only one
with
we can
our
turn
brokenness.
To. You're the
with
only one we turn to.
Oh, we turn to you, we come to you with our brokenness. With our brokenness, we run to you.
Only you. Verse 5 says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for the righteousness, for they shall be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. God, the world tells us that it's in our expression of strength and control that we would find what we need, that we would gain what we want. The world tells us to do whatever it takes to get the things we desire. No matter how dirty you have to get your hands, no matter what the cost, the world says the means justify the end. But that is not the way of the kingdom. God, you tell us that it's in our meekness that we find our inheritance. It's in our submission that we find our blessings. We are not meek because we lack strength. We are not meek because we don't know any better, because we don't have wisdom of our own. But we are meek because you are meek, Jesus. As a lamb before its shearers is silent, so were you. Even in the greatness of your strength, in the fullness of your wisdom, you chose to stay. stand down. You chose to allow others to rule. And so it's in our meekness that as you did, we will find our inheritance, that we will find our influence. And so God, we do not insist on our own way. We don't insist on our own way, God. Even though sometimes we think we know better, we think we're right, we choose to be meek. We choose to allow others to go first, to take control. Because no matter what the results look like, we know that our inheritance is not here on this earth. Even if things turn out contrary to what we want or expect, we know that it's in our meekness that we truly find our inheritance. And God, in this, we desire to inherit righteousness here on this earth. And may we be the ones who hunger most, who yearn most to see righteousness cover the earth as waters cover the sea. God, give us a clear understanding of what righteousness looks like in every situation. God, it's not black and white. It's not a formula. But Lord, righteousness is truly following your spirit in all that we do. And so God, we don't want to settle in moral gray areas. There's so many ways that we try to bend rules or make exceptions that are not pleasing to you. There's so many sins that we allow, that we coddle in our hearts because they're comfortable to us, because they're a safe, quote unquote, place for us. But God, we don't want that any longer. We want to pursue righteousness. We hunger for an end to this in our hearts first and in the world around us as well, God. We don't want to compromise to gain satisfaction that comes outside of your heart. We don't want to compromise to gain a satisfaction in the world, in the things that we our flesh desires. And so God, may we hunger and thirst for righteousness. Even understanding that even if something feels missing, it's not. That we're fully satisfied in you. That we have everything we need in you, Lord Jesus. And in that, may we hunger and thirst for a full righteousness, God. But at the same time, we don't want righteousness at the expense of love. We don't want justice at the expense of mercy, God. We don't want to take revenge. We don't want to hold debts because, Lord, you never did that to us. God, you came so that we would have no debts. You paid the price for us so that all our debts would be cleared, all of them erased, God. So Lord, we turn to you. We ask that you would transform our hearts. Give us a heart for righteousness and for mercy. Hearts for righteousness and mercy. God, out of meekness, in our strength, God. In the strength that we have in you, God.
Deliver us from the ways of the world.
our path straight.
This kingdom, we do not live for this kingdom, oh God. We do not live for this kingdom, we do not live for this kingdom, we do not live for this kingdom, oh.
What we see is not our kingdom.
We do not live for this kingdom, we do not live for this kingdom. Do not live for this kingdom.
Our kingdom is different.
Oh, we do not live for this kingdom. We do not live for this kingdom. We do not live for this kingdom. Oh, we're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now. Call us sons of God. We're citizens of heaven now. Yeah. We're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now. You call us sons of God.
We're citizens of heaven
now. We're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now.
We follow different
call
rules.
Us sons of God. We're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now. You call us sons of God.
Give us wisdom, God.
We're citizens of heaven now. We're citizens of heaven now.
Wisdom from your spirit.
We're citizens of heaven now. You call us sons of God. We're citizens. Citizens of heaven, a holy people, a royal priesthood, we're citizens of heaven.
Help us to know who we are.
Holy people, a royal priesthood, we're citizens of heaven. A holy people,
a
royal priesthood, citizens of heaven. A holy people, a royal priesthood, citizens of heaven.
We are meek,
a holy
God.
People, a royal priesthood, citizens of heaven. A holy people, royal priesthood, citizens of heaven. A holy people, a royal priesthood, citizens of heaven. We're sons of God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, sons of God, sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God, we're sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God, we're sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God. We're sons of God, we're sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God. We're sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God. We're sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of God, we're sons of God. We're sons of God, sons of a holy God. We're sons of a holy God. Sons of a holy God.
We're co-heirs with Christ.
We're sons of a holy God.
Make us more like you. Verse 8 says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. God, give us single-minded hearts. Single-minded hearts. Fully devoted hearts. God, there's so many things that try to split our attention, split our affections. But God, we know that there's greater. We know that there's greater. What we've seen so far does not satisfy. It does not satisfy. And so we turn our attention to you. We turn our affection to you. Help us to turn our affection to you, God. In every way, make us pure of heart. May we be transfixed, God, on you. Transfixed on you, God. And God, there's been so many reasons for us to have been divided from you. So many reasons for us to be cut off. But God, you came to reconcile us. You came to give us the ministry of reconciliation, God. And that is how we can even turn to you, how we can have this purity of relationship with you. And God, may we now translate that ministry of reconciliation into the world around us, into this world that also has so many reasons to be divided. God, there's so many reasons that we can point to hate someone, to separate ourselves. So many ways in which we can accuse others. But God, you've called us to a higher way. God, the world will know that we are sons. We are your sons when we choose to make peace. When we act, go out of our way to bring unity, to go out of our way to put ourselves lower, to let go of our self-righteousness and bring reconciliation and make peace with those around us. There's so many sides to choose. Some may even choose Christianity as a side. But Lord, your design is that we would all be one, that we would all be able to have peace with one another and love one another fully. So God, just as you came to restore our relationship, may we come and bring restoration in the relationships of the world around us, in the world around us, God, between people groups, between cities, between states and nations, God. May we bring peace, God, not just on individual levels, but on global levels, God. May we be the ones to declare peace. God, even in our efforts, we still receive so much persecution, God. Even though we want what is best for the world, there's a persecution that comes, God. And we recognize that there is some criticism that we get because of our failures, because of our inability to love. We recognize that some of the opposition we face is actually well-deserved. And so, God, we choose to face those things and correct ourselves and turn ourselves again to you for help. But, God, what we want to be is so countercultural. We want to be so extravagant in our worship and in our love and in our peacemaking and in our daily lives and everything that we do, that others would look at us and call us foolish, call us crazy. We want to live lives that would be such a threat to the status quo, that we would strike fear into the hearts of the enemy. God, that's the kind of extravagant life that we want to live. And so we welcome it. The persecution that we may face, God. We know that the enemy would want nothing more than to erase us, but God, we are safe in your hands. And so we have no fear of opposition. We have no fear of persecution, God. We have no fear, God. But in fact, we lean into it, God. Because we know that there's a beauty in pushing through and in facing this opposition, God. There's a blessing that truly comes when we choose to bring heaven to earth, God. So Lord, may give us the boldness that we need to face it. Give us the boldness that we need to live this countercultural lifestyle. This lifestyle that sees blessing not in this earth, not in what we can achieve here, not in what we can attain in this life. But may we live a life that is for the eternal, that is for the kingdom, that looks to a higher way, that sees blessing in what is not seen. God, give us that kind of life, that kind of mindset. Transform us, God, to look to the eternal, to look to the kingdom and find our blessing, God.
Our lives.
We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our lives even unto death. We don't want to live in you, but we will not love our l want to hold on to our lives.
We will not love our lives even unto
the lives that we have here in the flesh.
We will not love our lives
help
even
us,
unto
God.
Death.
We need you.
We will not love our lives even unto
death. Even this is grace.
We will not love our lives even unto death.
This ability is grace.
We would not love our lives even unto death.
We receive that grace.
We would not love
the grace
our
to not
lives
love
even
our lives.
Unto death. We would not love our lives even unto death, oh God.
At this time, we're going to transition to interceding for the nation of Israel. So we pray, I ask that you join with me as we pray. Engage your heart. Yeah, God. We confess that the church's heart towards Israel is not always in the right place. There's so many different opinions, so many different thoughts, so many different theologies that would try to remove Israel from your plan and from your story. But God, we recognize that it is in your heart. It is your promise, all the way that from Abraham to save Israel. And so, God, we ask that you would help us, help the church to recognize that Israel is still your chosen people. God, that you did not cut them off entirely, that you left a remnant even now. And God, we ask that you open up our hearts in the church, reveal scripture to us in the church. Give us right understanding, God, of what you think about Israel, God, in the church globally. God, we're so thankful that there are pockets of churches, so many ministries that do see Israel as your chosen nation. And so, God, we ask that those leaders would have the boldness to continue to carry that message and not just hold it to themselves, but really spread it and share it with the rest of the church, with the rest of the body, that we would all see clearly, that we would all be able to see clearly and move as one in praying for the church. So God, right now we ask for your help in bringing a right understanding to the church towards Israel. Let's pray.
eyes to see the God who does not fail, the God who does not fail.
Your promises are true, God.
Give us eyes to see the God who does not fail, the God who does not fail.
You see your promises through to the end.
For even when we are unfaithful, you are faithful.
Yes, God.
For even when we are unfaithful, you are faithful.
You are
God.
Not a man that you should lie.
For even when we fail, and even when we falter, you are the God who does not fail.
Your love never fails.
You are the God who does not
Your
fail.
Your love never fails.
Oh, help us see the God who is faithful.
Yes.
Oh, help us see the God who is faithful till the end. Your promise never fails.
Yes, God.
Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails.
Yes, God.
Your promises never fail. Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails.
Never fail.
Your promise never fails.
You see it through
your
to the end.
Your promise never fails.
See it through to the end.
Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails. Your promise never fails.
Yes, Father.
Your promise never fails.
Your promise never fails.
Your promise never fails.
You are faithful to the end.
You are faithful to your people, oh God.
Yes. Next, we want to take a moment to honor Israel, to honor them for the faith that they've already expressed, to honor them for laying the groundwork for the salvation that we have, for holding on in faith for years, for generations, that and never giving up. God, we honor them for holding on. And so we, God, pray that they would continue to hold on. Restore the hope that they have lost. Restore the hope that they have lost, God. For thousands of years, they've been looking for a Messiah that they believe has yet to come. And they may have hardened their heart. Many of them may have given up. But God, we pray that as they turn to you, that hope would be restored. That hope would be restored, God. That they would return to their faith. Return to the faith of their forefathers that we honor so greatly. And find hope in you. God, we ask that they would return. Yes, God. We honor them. We honor their faith. Let's pray.
Thank you.
next, we pray that there would be an end to all unbelief, God. That there would be an end to all stubbornness, all these stubborn hearts that refuse to turn to Jesus. We declare that Israel will be grafted back in, that they will receive the promises that you have promised, God. God, that is true. You will restore. And so, God, we declare an end to all unbelief, a restoration of hope in Christ. Yes, God, we pray for all unbelief to go, all stubbornness to go. Yeah, let's pray.
Hearts of stone would turn to flesh. Hearts of stone would turn to flesh. Hearts of stone would turn to flesh. Oh, this is the hour. This is the hour.
Yes.
When hearts of stone will turn to flesh. Hearts of stone will turn to flesh.
Yes.
Hearts of stone will turn to flesh. This is the hour. This is the hour.
Yes.
When hearts of stone will turn to flesh.
Now,
hearts of stone will turn to flesh. Hearts of stone will turn to flesh. This is the hour. This is the hour. For hearts of stone to turn to flesh.
For your glory, God.
Hearts of stone to turn to flesh. Hearts of stone to turn to flesh. This is the hour.
That glory would be given to you as promises are fulfilled.
For hearts of stone will turn to flesh. Hearts of stone will turn to flesh. Hearts of stone will turn to flesh. This is the hour. This is the hour. For hearts of stone to turn to flesh. Hearts of stone to turn to flesh.
Restore Israel.
For hearts of stone to turn to flesh. This is the hour. This is the hour. For hearts of stone to turn to flesh. Hearts of stone to turn to flesh.
You're turning hearts.
Hearts of stone to turn to flesh. This is the hour.
Right
this
now,
is
you're
the hour.
Hearts.
For hearts of stone to turn to flesh. Hearts of stone
right
to
now,
turn
you're
to flesh.
Hope.
Hearts of stone to turn to flesh.
In your people, Israel.
This is the hour. This is the hour,
is the hour.
Oh God.
God, right now we pray that glory would be seen as Israel is brought back to you, as we see unity in you, God. Yeah, Lord, we thank you that you are bringing a glory that we've never seen before. And so, Lord, we pray that we know that what we've declared tonight is going out right now. It's happening right now. Thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. Thank you, Lord, for the transformation that you're bringing to not just us, but to this world and to your people, Israel. So God, we just thank you for tonight. We thank you for tonight. Pray this in your name.